You know, you can be all the things you've always wanted to be. Beautiful, sexy, easy as 1, 2, 3.
Just let your soul glow. Just let it shine through. Just let your soul.
Shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you can rap to real. It's back, I'm back. It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you can rap to
what's up, what's up, what's up? What a time, my Damies. This is the Shoot from the Hip Show with the Montoys and the Reese back in here, dog. On a quick turnaround for y'all. I know y'all ain't used to it. You can catch us at 559-825-7468. That's how you get it off your chest. Tell us what you're thinking about. Shootfromthehip.xyz is the home base. That's where you get all of our content. And that's how you leave a beautiful donation, should you choose to do so. Shoot from the hip one@gmail.com is the email. You know, if you don't want to hear yourself talk, tell us what you think there. From the _hip on Twitter and Shoot from the Hip Share everywhere else. You know, and we back and we finna get this thing going, dog. Let your soul glow.
That's right.
How about that, man?
Just let you.
What was the inspiration for making that the show starter?
You know, usually I try and find something that take us back down memory lane. Something
yeah,
that was
that.
Funny.
Yeah.
Some. Well,
I grinned, dog. I was right back there.
When the rash would be, oh, that's.
I remember that.
Get you in the, open you up, like, okay.
This you know, I recently saw that.
Really?
I don't know where or why, but
I might have put it in the Instagram. Bro.
Maybe that was it.
That was, and I was supposed to go with that, but some shit probably
that's
happened.
That's what it was,
said,
right
man,
there.
You know
did
what?
That.
Yeah, so.
Oh, yeah, man. That's what I'm talking about, man.
Yeah, anyhow, like my partner over there said, it's the Shoot From The Hip Show, and we back. Shootfromthehip.xyz is the website. Go ahead and check that out.
Uh-huh.
Y'all ask for shows, then y'all don't never donate. We appreciate
and
it.
You ought to feel guilty.
A dollar show.
You around here laughing at us and ain't paying nobody. Come
or maybe
on.
We should start with something tight.
Yeah.
And then cut that motherfucker off.
And then just shut it off.
Yeah.
Like, what happened? You know, I did that one time.
Nah, we ain't going to do no shit like that.
I'm playing.
Unless it's lucrative enough for us to do that.
Yeah. I like lucrative, dog. That's a good word.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I know you say, L-U-critive.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, man. I got the joke, man.
Go ahead.
All right, man. Why do men find it hard to make eye contact with a woman?
I don't know.
Because titties don't have eyes. Look at routine up in here.
Man, you a nasty motherfucker.
I'm not. I'm far from nasty.
Oh, boom boom room looking ass.
Oh,
nigga.
There you go. Shout out to the No Nonsense.
That's right. Shout out to the No Nonsense. Shout out to all them guys over there. Again, we going to bitch to have each and every one of them over here.
Yeah.
Hopefully we can get French Rezzy before he succumbs.
French Rezzy.
Before he succumbs to his.
His corona?
Those, yeah.
No, I don't think that's going to be a thing.
All right, so we fresh off chilling. We were hanging out.
See, this is the thing. Reese loves, when we're about to do a show, Reese always say, hey, man, you want to get on Stogie first? I'm like, nigga, if I get on Stogie, I ain't going to be no good for the show.
Man, I love getting on Stogie before the show.
I know. I don't know how you do that.
What?
Because I'm going to drink if I'm going to smoke a Stogie usually.
Well,
I didn't really do much today.
I don't go full Hater Rossi guest appearance like you did.
Oh, way to bring back some old shit.
That's but fucked up.
Yeah, oh, I still got it. I just don't feel like that's a good representation of us.
I'm gonna hit him up. We gonna redo that.
Yeah, we gotta redo that.
Gotta redo that.
He got some shit coming.
I seen that.
Yeah.
Ain't no podcast. Just art.
Well, it looked dope.
I mean, all
I saw a video.
Dope. I seen that was dope.
That was dope as shit.
That was dope.
Shout out to the Hater Rossi, man. Yeah, we shout see y'all there.
Boy. And I hit him up. I told you I hit him up when I was in Vegas.
Yeah.
He had some shit going on with his old lady.
Yeah, well. That happens.
Yeah, it does happen.
Uh-huh.
And we back shoot from here one@gmail.com. If you want to send us an email, we appreciate those too. Although we never get them, that lane is always available for you to use.
But we did have a handful of voicemail come through.
We got breath.
Plenty.
Many time tiny?
Not one, but many time tiny.
All right. So the Montoyas is hanging out with me fresh after staying out all night.
Yeah, the old lady is not going to be happy. I'm going to have to do some special shit today. Nigga, like, you know, go get some crawfish, something. You know, she loves that. I was supposed to bring it home last night, but I was out too long.
Well, last longer than 5 minutes, she'll be appreciative.
Hey, there you go.
Yeah. Well, you drink your, eat your seaweed or whatever you got going on.
Well, yeah, my black seed oil.
There you go.
And my sea moss.
There you go.
I'm on it, dog.
Hey, man.
I feel younger every day.
So how did last night go?
Oh, man, last night was dope. I hung out with my boy Anthony and his brother and another co-worker.
Hold on. I do believe Anthony's your daddy's son. I'm just saying.
Well, we close.
Yeah.
We look alike. I know, you know, his mama even said.
Right. I'm just saying.
He's like, that's your brother that's not related to us. But I got another homie like that, my boy Nick.
Yeah.
When I first moved to Mo City, that was my first friend.
Yeah.
Still my homie to this day. And I used to go over there, and they said we looked alike.
Maybe your daddy was a traveling man.
Traveling man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Not a Mason.
So you said yesterday was dope. You started out by going to the Gallo.
I went to the Gallo, copped me a little fit, man.
There you go.
Not all in one place because, you know, I just got to do it the hard way.
I
found some shoes. I went and found some pants, some sweatpants to go with the shoes. Then I found a shirt that corresponds with all of it.
Mm.
You know, that's congruent with all of it, if you will. And man, then I shot on over to Anthony's house. We did a little pre-gaming.
Yeah.
Then we went to Papa Do's.
Papa Do.
No, we didn't go to Nigga Do's. No, right. I ain't never going back there.
I am. I like it.
No, I don't.
It gets a bad name, but
well,
it's just a place where black people tend to
meet. I was there when some stuff went down, and I said, you know what, man?
Well, I mean, shootings can happen anywhere.
Can, but I wasn't there. I'm just saying, I was a little too close this time. That time, I ain't doing that no more.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we went to the Papa Do's in Stafford, man. We hung out, and it was cool, chopping it up. Then we went to the Mo City Sports Bar.
In the Mo.
Come on, dog.
Come on, man.
You know, that's like Cheers for black folks in Mo City.
It is.
And I walked in there, man, and the owner of the place, she knew all of us. Like, when I go in there, they tell me Anthony
so
was just
So it transitioned
there.
Back to black?
Yeah.
Because it was got white
it kind of It kind of got a little white. I wouldn't say it went all the way white, but white folks was welcome. But it was always black. But I was in there so tough.
I'm talking
tough.
About the bartenders.
Oh, the bartenders were scantily clad.
That's a thing now.
Yeah, well, they was there. Man, I saw cleavage and all kind of stuff last night. And I didn't really talk to them. I was talking to the one bartender. It was a dude. He had one of his eyes was shooting left. And one of them was shooting straight, and he remembered me, man. He was like, man, I saw your boy the other day. And then Anthony walked in, so there you go right there. Y'all getting the same thing? Yeah, we getting the same thing. There you go. That's what I like.
He gets down. So what kind of whiskey did you drink?
Well, I had Makers.
That's what Anthony was drinking?
No, that boy drank a Long Island. He drank like a teenager, you know.
We still doing Long Island in 2020, dog.
Hey, drink like a teenager, man.
Those don't work on my gut. It's too much.
It's something funny in there. And yeah. When you was young, and that was the shit to get, because it was a lot of alcohol in there, you wanted to show how hard you was.
Yeah.
But nah, bro.
My T's be Long Island.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who is that?
Jada Kiss. Yeah.
Jadakiss. Boy, we was at, where were we at when we was watching a Jadakiss video?
Outside the other night, I believe.
Yeah.
it kept popping up.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
I'm grimy, V.
Yeah, so you did that.
Did that,
got
man.
Home a little late.
Got home very late because I went to my dad's house and we partied some more because he's about to retire. He copped him some new property. You understand? It was cool. He was so happy and gave me a key to the place. Cause you know I'm the high tech Texan in my family.
Yeah.
So I was like, he was telling me about how, you know, they don't really get a TV signal out there and all that. It's like, let me at it. I figure it out.
Uncompressed,
dog. I do it all day.
Okay.
So I got a key to the spot. Ain't that a bit?
It is.
I gotta get out there.
Yeah.
Probably next week.
Okay.
Yeah, man. It's a
Northside 7.
No.
What?
No.
Yes.
No.
Very much so. No. That's right up the alley.
Northside 7 ain't leaving the city limits of Houston much.
They go to fucking to the
I
beach.
I mean, they go to party somewhere.
Mississippi?
They not going to my old man's spot.
Shh, the fuck they not?
They not.
They coming in with the boy.
Yeah. We'll see.
I'm going to make it happen. Fuck that.
That's funny. I don't see it happening.
Watch this shit.
Hey, man, we a little more country than they are.
No.
Well, I'm not. We
is not. No, y'all
we
our country.
Me and my
but
side.
But the Northside 7 will get together for a party.
They
now.
Will get around.
Yeah,
they. But they gotta kind of see it for it happen.
No, they gonna do it for you.
No, they not.
Do it for Monty.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe. But yeah, dog, you was around here scrambling before the show kicked off.
Old lady got a high tech. Instrument panel on the car, and it said you down to your oil is low.
You need to get it
on
changed.
A Saturday
at the end o'clock. Of working hours.
Yeah, I'm scrambling.
You were scrambling like a son, boy.
Man, I called OZ.
You were scrambling like a black quarterback.
Yeah,
I said, look at him. He going, boy. Standing on the phone.
Hey, man, got she straight now.
Oh, it worked, boy. You put in about an hour, you know, a phone calling back and forth.
Man,
couldn't even sit outside and enjoy the stogie, man.
Man, oh.
Come
man.
On, dog.
I hate them kind of phones.
Yeah,
calls.
Well.
Yeah.
Well, you the right man for it.
Yeah, I guess, you know.
Because it had to be a specific spot for you.
So y'all were in here with us. Y'all might notice that I am wearing glasses because my right eye is fucked up.
Yeah, man. It's a little red.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's very fucked up, but it's a little red. Look like you got allergies.
That's what I was putting in my eye at first. Uh-huh. I don't have allergies.
I've been scratching my eyes too lately, man. I'm pollen and jumped off around.
Well, Houston. I heard it's a, somebody told me it's a thing. I don't know if it was Ashton or somebody. Then I fuck around and had to go make me a doctor appointment and got the shit that really worked.
Yeah.
I started calling mother-in-law.
Hey, you should have.
I really should have.
Yeah.
And just say, hey, give me some medicine. Save me. Because what happened was I scheduled an appointment. I went to work and I'm like, this ain't going to work. They're like, all right. I came home, scheduled me an appointment for 12:15. And then I'm sitting around my wife like, you need to hurry up. Got on the freeway heading down 59. And traffic is moving at 40 to 45 miles
an hour. I saw a post on Instagram about, hey, people, stop moving to Houston. We full. Go somewhere else.
You for real?
I'm telling you, dog. Because Houston ain't like no vacation destination type of place.
At all.
You know, people that live here, from here, we love it. And you go outside, you can't wait to get back. But I wouldn't be like, hey, you need to come here on vacation.
Mm-hmm.
It wouldn't be that. But this motherfucker's full.
Man, it's money to be made.
Hey, it's money being made, and they are here for it.
They are here for
it. All kind of different nationalities and shit. Mm-hmm. I saw something where we like the most diverse city in the country.
I can see that.
The culinary capital of the South.
Got niggas. You got essays. You can drop a ping.
You got Africans.
Oh, yeah, that's heavy.
You got Indians.
Yeah.
Like real Indians.
Africans out here chasing light-skinned women.
Uh-huh. You got Chinatown. You got two Chinatowns.
You got Asians out here selling us fucking hair and beauty supplies.
You got Vietnamese people selling us crawfish.
Yeah.
Ain't that a bitch? I don't trust that.
Who gonna sell us these N45 face masks?
Well, nigga.
Amazon?
I was at the gallery and I saw a few masks walking around there.
Oh, really?
That was funny.
Okay.
I was like, man, you just looking for attention. You clout chasing.
For real.
Get out of here.
They supposed to have it in San Antonio.
I heard. College Station. Yeah. All right there, man. I don't buy it, dog. I'm not buying into this coronavirus shit. I feel like it's some news drumming up some more shit, man. I don't buy it, man. I'm just there. I don't see it enough. Maybe I need to be around it to believe it's real.
Yeah.
But I feel like it's some trumped up, contrived shit that got everybody whipped up in a frenzy.
I don't know, dog.
I don't buy it, man.
nigga, the economy is all fucked up.
Yeah. That was the point.
Do you put into any like 457 or 401k or anything?
Yeah.
Well, I guess you would know that you get your next statement, I guess. Man, I get mine in the mail.
What I know is leave that shit alone.
Yeah.
Just let it grow. It's like smoking a brisket. If you're looking, you ain't cooking.
Okay, speaking of brisket.
All right.
So the other day I was at Heeb.
H-E-B for y'all that don't know.
The Harry Butts.
Whoa. Is that his name?
Yeah.
I thought it was something different.
No.
The B wasn't Butts, was it?
It's Butts.
Wow. I think it might make me stop going.
Hey, nah, you indebted.
I know, right? Big time.
Yeah, your daughter's in
there. My daughter's in there, and she's like moving up within the ranks over there.
There you go.
That's funny.
Mm-hmm.
I remember when H-E-B was just San Antonio.
I remember when it first came.
Well, I mean, when it hit
the first one that I remember was on Derry Ashford and like Bissonnette.
Okay.
That's the first
deep one. In the SWAT.
Yeah.
I see you.
What was I saying? I was going somewhere.
Okay. We talked about the Heeb. And he said something about, I said something about brisket. You said speaking of brisket.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of brisket, they have three of them. Three Wagyu briskets.
Oh, stay away from it.
No?
Mm-mm.
You did your research?
I've had some Wagyu
brisket,
and no, not brisket, steak. But just steak. And I've been watching it on YouTube. Remember when I had my me time?
Yeah,
I saw a bunch of Wagyu videos. The fat and all that is so rich, dog. It don't taste like regular steak. It's buttery. I mean, if you're into that,
well, it's $100 for a brisket.
I bet.
I was gonna do it.
Mm-mm.
But it's 17 pounds. If they had 12, I could do. But I can't do 17 pounds of smoking meat.
I think there's too much fat in that makes it all soft and mushy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want my steak like that.
$100, though. I was going to get one.
Well, I mean, go for it. Believe me, you make it, and I'm gonna try it, but I'm not a fan.
Well, but I want it to be 12 pounds around that area.
It shouldn't go. 17? For the house? Nah, you don't want to go past like 12. Because you be cooking.
And I don't mind giving it away, but somebody like the BYT that'll come and eat
Wagyu, though, you don't want to get that away.
Well, again, like you just say, you come over, you say, ooh, nigga.
Yeah.
Or I even Cisco Grizzly.
Yeah.
Come through, he want to give it a shot. He made his presence felt on the last brisket I made.
Hey.
But I know I'm going to get some on the back end.
Hey, man.
And it ain't about.
He pays it forward.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So, get somebody like the BYT or Ashley to come over this bitch.
They don't really pay it forward.
They just come with a plate.
They just come with their hands out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, all right.
You know, and you don't get the return.
You don't want no
you
Wagyu.
You fuck around and give the BYT some Wagyu, and next time a fight come here, order don't call you.
Oh, way to call it back.
You get a shot for the BYT, not giving a fuck about nobody else but himself. Bang. All right. Why are we talking this? I got some questions that I want to ask in there. I really would like, I want you to think about this while we're recording. I got to call a female. I really have a question that I would like to ask a female about some content that I want to talk about. So if you could think about somebody we can call while we're doing this after the break.
Okay.
So if you got somebody, I'm.
Well, I don't have no female friends like that. So.
Well, you know I do.
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
Yeah. Well, nigga.
But
don't put that evil on me, nigga.
But I'm interested in giving one of them a call because I have a question I want to ask, and I want my opinion, your opinion. And I would like the BYT and Ashton to be here for this one because it's funny, it's fucked up, but it's a good question to talk about.
Oh, it sounds like this got legs on it.
Well, we'll see.
All right. Well, let's go for it, man.
All right. That will be the part of our fuckery because it is that.
Okay.
And we talking about fucking.
I can't wait for this. I feel like I have an idea where this going.
All right. 559-825 7468 559-825
shot.
This is Shoot From Here Show. Let's get a gunshot. Start talk about some news. All right. Tom Byron Steeman of Maryland. He attacked a woman outside of a grocery store.
So it's three names.
Well, first, middle, last.
That's what I mean.
When you throw it in the middle, that's kind of like
some. Usually, that's some white dude killing somebody.
Okay.
All right. We'll go for it.
All right. So he attacked a woman out. She was exiting the store and married her. I'm going to say Churton or Churchton. You can look this up and get a chance. He bumped into her. She said something like a bee sting or a cigarette burn.
Oh, no.
After investigation was later found, after the investigation was later done, if he poked her with a syringe as she walked by. Now, Thomas Byron Steeman poked her with a syringe full of his semen.
Oh!
Yeah.
Way to make that rhyme.
Right.
So he injected her with some spooge.
Yeah.
Like where? Where did he inject that?
If you see the video, he walked by like he poked her in her butt.
Yeah. He tried to get there.
Yeah.
I'm laughing, but that's not cool.
It ain't.
It's that's fucked up all the way around.
Yeah. So he's in jail. They say they're probably going to be many more victims of this guy.
I mean, but I'm trying to think how do you inject that? I mean, needles are small.
I mean, you got like the one
spooge needs a shaft. You ain't gonna get nowhere with no needle.
Maybe he's a dirty dick nigga.
He dirty something.
And
he's a dirty needle.
I like to skeet on you.
That's some white boy shit. All
I want to see you play with it a little bit.
He's white. Okay, all right.
I want to see you play with it and rub it all on you and
like lotion.
Yeah.
Okay, it's good for the skin.
Yeah,
that's what I hear.
Yeah,
I wouldn't know.
Well, I would hope the fuck not.
Yeah, nigga, I don't spooge on myself. Yeah.
All right. So anyway, y'all.
Nigga, where you get that news from, man? What's the source of that, man?
Fox.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh.
You think I'm fucking around?
No, I mean you found it. That's nigga. I don't know. People.
I remember a few years ago there was a guy
like she didn't know he did it. How they found out that he was the one that did it?
I think she complained about it, and his reaction was like, what happened when they bumped into each other? He's looking around, and then I don't know. She might have made a complaint or felt some kind of way, or she could have felt something, and then
semen in her booty,
or did a police report, and then they went and pulled the video.
Okay, all right.
And all then right. The video shows him clearly sticking
found
him
steaming in
steaming stuck it with his semen.
Steaming injecting semen.
Yeah.
See, I feel like that's fake, dog.
Yeah, it's a real deal.
The name fucks it up for me.
Thomas Byron Steeman. Google it. See what you come up with.
Man, I
just Google
it.
The name as
you
I continue
got it
to
from
talk.
Snopes, nigga.
Hey, I'm just saying. All right.
In Maryland.
Yeah.
Maryland people are weird, by the way.
We are weird.
No, we are all not weird.
Okay.
When I was in the Navy, dog. it was certain factions of people I met from different places.
Yeah. We listen to go-go music.
Well, that's part of it. But it seemed like every time I met a cat from Maryland, there was some off shit. Something was off.
Mm.
Every time. Them in Florida.
Yeah.
They were off, dog. And, you know, shout out to Dallas, but Dallas, they was off too.
Yeah.
I was like, something was wrong there.
Yeah.
Wrong or just not all the way on the up and up.
Yeah. All right, moving along here on the Shoot for the Hip show. Tony Romo, he was almost.
Speaking of Dallas.
He was almost a free agent for us when it comes to signing the next deal where he would be broadcasting that or being an NFL analyst.
We talked about that last night.
Oh, yeah, I did?
Yeah.
$17 million per annual salary of $17 million.
Hey.
Now, Stephen A. Smith was the highest.
He's a friend of mine.
Yeah. He doubled that. Now, Stephen A. Smith duties are insane. To do 2 hours of live TV 5 days a week.
Yeah.
Do like one or two sports centers for basketball.
And Romo just eclipsed that shit.
Doing 16 weeks of football. Well, I mean, then that was a thing. They were saying that Romo was calling shit out before it happened.
I saw it. I watched him call this.
But that's 3 hours. And if you talk.
The money don't make no sense.
He shouldn't make more than, dang it. What's the guy? The guy, Jim Nance. He should not make more than Jim Nance.
Hey, man, you are worth what they're going to pay you.
Well, that's true.
But and all I know is that boy, he was pretty damn good.
He ain't worth $17
million. If I was running a company, I wouldn't give him that. If I knew the layout of the land and know
he
who's getting paid.
He ain't worth more than Jim Nance?
No, I wouldn't say he was.
Man, what it is, this football shit, it just, they place too much value on it. Because I believe the world will go on whether football's here or not. And yep. I know people tune in all over the, you know. But I don't know that people are tuning in for Tony Romo. There was a thing back in the day, the guy, Howard Cosell, he was a big deal, especially with Monday Night Football. And that was a thing.
Yeah.
But, I mean, I don't know necessarily that we consume, because you could turn it down and kind of play on your phone, talk to people in the room, and you're still watching the game. You're still into it, but you're not paying attention necessarily. And I am very into it, but you're just not paying attention to when Romo call or not blitz and certain packages.
I'm not into it as much as you are, but it was very noticeable when Romo was calling stuff on the TV. He was calling for it. I saw it. He called it before it happened. Oh, they're manning up. He got an inside, this, that, and the other one. It's open. He should go there. Yeah. And bam, he went there.
Yeah.
He did it every damn Sunday.
He got kind of called out for it a little bit.
Well, I don't. They can not be mad.
It's just like, goddamn, dude, you taking away the goddamn surprise. He's the element of surprise.
Yeah, well, I'd say this. Whoever's paying him know what they got.
17, dude.
That's a lot. I know. I'm just saying, though. I've watched football casually for a long time. And most of the time, the commentators repeat shit I've heard before.
Well, I don't know that he's necessarily better than Chris Collinsworth.
Yeah, he is.
I don't know. Nah, Chris Collinsworth.
Because I don't even like listening to that guy.
See, for me, I believe when you can sound knowledgeable and also say something that's necessarily not popular. And I don't believe Romo has that. Because Chris Collinsworth will say something. He's like, man, what the fuck? They do it. It's Shoot for the Show. Yeah. What the fuck Reese talking about? Yeah. They're dangling. Say, man, how you just going to be hating on it? But that, not because you piss me, but you bringing up conversation and you make people not all the way piss them off to where they hate you. But, I mean, there's some Tony Romo just calling out shit that he should be able to do.
Well, he should be able to do.
I guess maybe he's that.
And he's the first one to do what he's doing. Like, come on, dog. How many times?
Shout out to the shit.
Yeah, there you go. How many times have you watched it and somebody called the play? Why are they talking about it? I've never seen that tell Romo.
I used to do it all the time with the Texans back in the day.
Oh, that's different. We all can do that. They so predictable. But, yeah, Romo was like on some savant type shit. Okay. And it make you wonder why he went better as a quarterback.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Well, that was the argument I had with
him. He's saying it off on the TV looking at the game. Why couldn't he be in the game doing the same shit?
Yeah, he should have knew what was coming.
That's right.
He was a great quarterback.
Bad back. He got hit.
Yeah.
You can't get hit in the commentator booth.
Did he win a playoff game? I don't think he won a playoff game.
I don't think so.
All right. Moving along here. Catherine Pugh of Baltimore. She was sent
to here we go again.
What?
Maryland.
Oh, yeah.
Go ahead.
DMV.
Mm-hmm.
She sent to federal prison for 3 years. Now she's 7 years old. She was sent for fraud and tax charges.
How old?
70.
Okay.
She's the former mayor of Baltimore.
Black woman.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember her. Mm. Yeah. Now, what'd she get sentenced for?
Tax and fraud charges.
For real?
Yeah.
She ain't gonna do no time for that. That's what they do over there.
Well, she's still a convicted felon.
Joe Blanquito, what they got you for? Income tax evasion. Shout out to Chef with Peoples.
Hey, man. So anyway, this brings me back to what Trump said. It's a rat hole, shithole with a man, Elijah, and her. And you know, Baltimore has some of the worst schools.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shout out to The Wire.
Yeah. It's based on the fuckery that goes on there.
Hey, man. I said it earlier. There's some shit going on over there where people come out weird.
Yeah,
I said it. I saw it, and all you doing is affirming the shit I said. Look at hey y'all. Inside,
I'm trying to finish the
inside
shit.
Baseball, y'all. We over here doing the show. Reese is squigging Crown Royal out the bottle.
Vanilla.
Oh, it's vanilla too. Oh, he really on some nigga shit.
Hey man, I'm trying to finish the shit.
Well, good man. It shit need to be finished.
It does.
He over here swigging out the thing, dog. So if y'all hear him and shit starts sounding funny. The way I used to be. Man, blame it on the Crown Royal vanilla.
All right. Moving
old
along.
Old flavored
here.
Whiskey drinking ass.
There's a Miller in Milwaukee. They have the Miller Coors. Beer is big there.
Yeah.
It was bought by Molson. So it changed to Molson Coors. Now, I drank Molson Ice.
Molson?
Yeah, Molson. I drank Molson Ice when I was in the military. A guy that I knew.
Okay.
He's from Jersey. And back then there was a Bud Ice. There was this ice thing going on with these
Just like black became a thing for a minute.
Yeah. So anyway, they bought the I guess the main distribution center in Milwaukee, the beer distributor.
Wow. Are they US?
Huh?
Molson. That's US?
That's East Coast.
Okay.
Some up north.
Because you know, Budweiser got bought out by some company in Germany.
Oh really?
Yeah. Yeah. I kind of felt some kind of way.
Yeah, we know.
I don't think we know, nigga. I ain't never said that.
There was an active shooter there at the warehouse.
Oh no.
Yeah, Anthony Farrell, 51 years
old. Hold on, he don't have a middle name?
No.
He ain't white then.
No.
Come on, dog. I'm not making this up.
There's 1,000 employees working. He came in and shot 5, then killed himself.
Damn.
Yeah.
Just kill yourself. Don't take nobody with you.
Man, maybe he ain't want to go through the gates by himself.
He ain't going. How you know he going to the gates?
He might want to see cut. What now?
Oh, you about to do it. He's about to do it.
No.
Who he going to see, dog?
Lucifer.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. He'll keep that where it's at.
All right. This the shoot.
It wasn't no
show.
Rap killing.
559-825 cell phone 6855-9825 shot. Make sure y'all give us a call. Tell us how you feel.
Yeah.
At the least, you don't want to donate, you can give us a call and let us know you still fucking with us and we still popping up on your timeline and shit. You could delete us and say, man, fuck these niggas, man.
Yeah.
Like, Reese hate black people.
Oh, hating ass.
D-Montoys think everybody's supposed. Somebody posted that. Who posted that? We just talked about it.
Yeah, it was Silver Surfer.
Standing at a herd. Oh, this standing at a herd.
Yeah.
And hey, Milwaukee.
I believe in that. Hey, man, some shit happened to people for a reason, man.
All right, so we finna take a break. We're going to come back with your voicemails and some fucker. We're going to figure out a female we can call and maybe have this conversation. If not, we just going to talk about it amongst ourselves.
You speaking French.
All right, we'll come right back. This is Shoot from the Hip Show.
Yep.
The day Kobe gained my respect was the guys were complaining. I said, Shaq, Kobe's not passing the ball. I said, I'll talk to him. I said, Kobe, there's no I in team. And Kobe said, I know, but there's an in me in that mother.
Hey, how about that?
And we back. This is the Shoot from the Hip Show.
There's no I in team.
There's no I in team.
I said the ME thing back when like ninth grade.
Did you?
Yeah, that was not a new thing to me.
Yeah, but
it brought the house down though.
It did do that.
I guess.
What you mean you guess?
I guess, man.
Ain't no different than that joke in your shit.
I'm trying to stay away from being disrespectful, man.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to do. So I shouldn't have said I guess, because that sounded disrespectful in itself.
Are you a disrespectful nigga?
I'm not. I just, you know, I'm lackadaisical, you know.
Lackadaisical.
Lack. Is it lack?
I don't know.
Look at you correcting my shit. Mr. Third Grade Reading Level.
I'm on
there.
Third Grade Reading Level, man. It is what it is.
Well, maybe let's see.
I don't be understanding.
Let me see if it's right, man. I'm gonna ask Google.
Okay.
What's the definition of lackadaisical?
Here's the definition of lackadaisical.
Oh, you said it
lacking
right.
Lacking enthusiasm and determination. Carelessly lazy.
Okay, all right then.
You're lacking.
Lackadaisical.
There you go.
I better stop. You know, that's like when black folks say axe.
Yeah.
Instead of ask.
Yeah. See and saw.
Yeah. I synced that.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. All right, lackadaisical. Man.
Hey, man.
My heart felt like you was right, but I wanted to battle that.
That's that mo in you.
No, that's not the mo. That's my family.
The crab.
My family, a bunch of know-it-alls.
Okay.
And so we always look for where you're wrong at, even if you're right. Yeah, anyway, man. Shout out to Kobe.
Yeah.
I was a fan.
Me too.
Yeah, I liked it.
I got two, matter of fact.
Yeah.
He right there.
Yeah, I know.
And I had three pair of Kobe Bryant tennis shoes. I gave one away to
my daughter's
godson.
Okay.
I mean, I'm sorry.
No.
My wife's godson.
All right.
You finna say something. Go ahead.
You seen that shit with Joel Embiid and Harden?
No.
Is it Antetokounmpo?
Antetokounmpo.
And Harden?
Yeah.
What's that about?
I don't know. I mean, I think a lot of people feel that way about Harden in the NBA.
Yeah?
I think so.
So why are them two going?
I don't know why he taking shots at Harden.
I saw
like
something on the internet about Harden being a local at Rice University here in Houston.
A local?
Like, he's always there.
Harden?
Yeah.
He want him a smart chick.
Well, seem like Giannis got a gal from Rice.
I can see that. Now, I heard Harden gets busy out there. And hey,
Giannis got a gal from Rice, apparently. That's what I saw. And now
that girl go to Rice?
I saw the picture. I don't know if it's true or not.
She
you know,
was
the internet.
A child. She gave birth soon, recently.
Oh, shit.
They Harden and been there?
Man, I don't know. I'm just saying. I saw the picture. I'm like, first. Maybe it's something there.
Yeah.
That's all I got.
Okay, did he come out with a beard?
Well, we'll see. Did that nigga do the jump back?
Is he left-handed? Is he wearing Adidas?
Do he cry after he lay up?
You know, I got some Giannis shoes.
Really?
Yeah, I've only worn them like once.
Well, nigga, don't run in them. I'm playing. I'm fucking around.
All right. Back, man. This is Shoot From His Show. After the break, we get to that fuckery and your voicemails. And as much as y'all like being part of the show, we like it as well because yes, we want to hear what y'all want to get off y'all chest. 559-825-7468. 559-825-SHOT. How much we got?
We got 5, man.
Cinco?
Cinco.
All right, where the first one coming from?
From the 904.
Oh, wait a minute.
You know who it is.
Hope, stop.
All right.
This is some build up.
Duval.
This is some build up right here.
All right.
All right, let's go. Hold on. Is it Cisco or is it?
Cisco.
Okay, I thought it was Chill.
No, she's Miami. That's 305.
Okay, all right.
Oh, or the whatever number she called from. Okay. Base.
Well, shout out to Chill, man. We miss you. Holler at us, homegirl.
Yeah. All right, man. Let's see what he got to say.
Hey, what's going on, fella? Cisco Grizzly. Hey, man, I just wanted to comment. Y'all talking about these kids. How soft they are. Let me tell you, man, I got 3 boys. So, hey, I teach my kids how to lose. That's what's wrong with these kids. They don't know how to lose. Hey, we go outside and play basketball, I body their ass up. Kareem Abdul Jabbar.
There you go.
They some little ass guard down there. Hey, they got to learn how to lose. They need to know their feeling, what it is. You can't win all the damn time. But anyway, man, hey, Montoya's bro, next time we go to a football game, we're going to have to watch you Saturday night, dog. So every time we travel, you be having a bad Sunday morning. I ain't never seen somebody throw up as much as you do on a Thursday. Nigga need Jesus. But anyway, man, quick story real fast. I just flew back from D.C., man. I'm on the plane next to this cute black chick. You know, she cute. She got all her little Greek letters on, Greek sweater, everything, you know. So I asked her, I say, what sorority are you part of? And she said, are you serious? I said, yeah, I'm serious. Now, what sorority are you part of? She said, where'd you go to college? I said, I went to PV. And I said, you know, I went to TSU. She said, how you go to an HSBC? And you don't know what this means. I said, well, shit, I don't know. What the fuck is it? She said, I'm a Delta. I'm like, oh, okay, I'm cool. You know, good on you. So I asked her something in French. And she said, oh, I'm sorry, I don't speak French. I said, well, fuck, I don't speak Greek either. How the fuck can I say I know this shit right here? Anyway, she ain't talking for the rest of the flight, but I thought that shit was funny. But anyway, fellas, man, y'all have a good one, dog. I'll holler at y'all boys later.
All right, Cisco.
That boy said HSBC.
Yeah.
HBCU, my brother.
Yeah, well, I was going to let that go.
You had to
point it out.
Hey,
Look at you. You an old correcting ass nigga
no,
this
I'm
show.
No, I'm not.
Look at you.
Not at all.
That's funny. Lackadaisical. I see you.
My wife is trying to be active in her sorority again.
Is that right?
Yeah.
I mean, is it like... Does it fulfill her or does it like, you know,
no.
She gets something out of it?
But I think she feels a kind of way about all of her friends being active and she not being active.
Man. I feel some kind of way about having to belong to a
I do
group.
Too. I'm not into that.
I don't have that in me, man, to need to be around some people.
Yeah.
Like, hey, man.
My personal opinion, it's not a shout out to anybody who's Greek. If you listen to the show, if you are Greek, when you next time you call in, let us know what you are.
Yeah.
But I mean, I just don't lead with anything. I just tell you what kind of person I am.
Hey man, I
it doesn't define me.
One of my monikers is I lead from the rear. And really it's just that I don't follow.
Yeah.
I don't need to lead. I just ain't gonna follow. That's it.
Yeah.
I be by myself and nobody has to fuck with me. I'm cool.
Yeah,
I don't need to be involved in no organization like that. But I found out that my grandfather was a Mason.
Oh, yeah?
And I was like, well, man, I should look into it.
Mm.
It's just that, man, I feel like there's some shit in there that I don't, I'm not going to be cool with.
You might jump in and jump right out.
See? And if I'm going to do that, I just might as well not even jump in.
Yeah. And it's almost like sometimes if somebody's the same fraternity you're in, you almost feel like you have to help them. You might not like them.
Right. Right. Yeah. You ever work with somebody you don't like, but all y'all's time. Y'all's mission, y'all's goal is the same,
mm-hmm.
but you don't like that motherfucker.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't want to be in that position.
Yeah.
Now, screw that, dog. If I don't like you, dog, I don't want nothing to be. I don't want to be involved with nothing you do.
Yeah.
Anyway, man, shout out to Cisco, dog. That's funny.
Yeah, but
how
also,
you go to an HSBCU and they're not know what the Greek stuff is.
Yeah.
Come on, man.
Well, and as far as teaching your kids how to lose, you need to holler at me on that.
That's real.
That is real.
That's real. Mm-hmm. They need to know what an ass whooping feel like.
Yeah.
You know, that way you
know
learn.
You're all about tough love.
Maybe. I mean, it's natural for me. Yeah, I don't know. I know how to lose. I've lost before.
You had on Rydell's, dog.
Yeah. And stepped into school, knew it was coming. I knew I was gonna get clowned.
Shout out to Rydell.
Hey man, I'm telling you, I ought to be a damn spokesperson.
You should. Hey, Kawhi Leonard wearing New Balance.
See?
That's losing.
New Balance is cool though.
No, they are not.
See, here we go.
That's you are the
okay. It cooler than Rydell's, nigga.
Yeah.
I just bought some Adidas yesterday.
Yeah, you ain't losing with that.
Yeah, well, you shit on them.
Well, that's because I'm a Nike guy.
I know. But these hoes clean, nigga.
See that, nigga?
I see it.
See that, nigga?
I hope they pay you for that. See, he's showing you all his Nike shit. This boy is Nike head to toe right now. Everything except for the headphones and a microphone.
That is Apple.
Yeah. See that?
Know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Some of elitist ass.
Not elitist.
Wannabe upper crust, cream of the crop ass, you know, bougie ass shit. Well, enjoy it, brother.
I did tell my wife that she goo up now.
Good.
She at Gringo's.
Okay.
Yeah, hope she get drunk and get horny.
You know what a gringo is, yo?
White boy.
White boy mask.
Yeah.
She gonna get white boy drunk.
Yeah. I hope so.
There you go.
She. All right. Moving along here, shooting. Where that next one coming from?
Oh, the next one here is coming from the 281, and that is what? Our own backyard. All right, man, let's see what they got to say. Hold on.
What up, though? It's your boy DJ, the DJ. Back in the building. Just started the show. 10 minutes into the show. Now we got D-Mail Toys being slammed to it. I gotta call him and disagree with the dog. I gotta keep the same energy. Look, man, Deontay just lost the fight. Like, it's not for no other reason. Like, so think about this, right? Floyd Mayweather never lost the fight. He was showy, right? As you say.
Yeah.
But he's undefeated. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you just don't lose. Sometimes you do lose. Mike Tyson. For all that you said about Mike Tyson, right?
Show up and kick
come
ass.
Come in the ring just for one reason only. Still caught some L's though, didn't he? Yeah, he got it. His one loss was worse than Deontay's loss.
No, it wasn't. No. Nope.
And again, we know he had more than one loss, but his loss against Buster Douglas means more heavyweight boxing.
You're right.
Than Deontay's loss to Tyson Fury.
I agree.
Because people didn't think, like, people had never seen a chink in. What's McCollum's armor and Mike Tyson's armor? Like the last fight, some people say Deontay lost. And they say he was given a draw. But we hadn't seen that from Tyson. Tyson went in there again, no frills, nothing. Still caught that L though. Still caught all of L's versus, well, he got two losses versus Evander. He went in there and got beat up by Lennox Lewis, wanted to kiss him in the face after the fight. But he wasn't showy. So in a sport that's just that brutal. Sometimes you're just gonna lose, regardless of how you do it. And I don't mind you doing whatever works best for your personality. Because I'm a huge Floyd Mayweather fan, I'm a huge Andre Ward fan. You know? And Andre Ward with no frills, like, you know, none of the extra antics. That's his personality. And I expect that from him. I'm saying Errol Spence Jr. Again, like, he ain't no big showy guy. Terrence Crawford, not cool. You know what I mean? So whatever works for you. But like, if you got personality and you're using it, I ain't mad at it. You know what I'm saying? And you can fight and unless you want to be you'll still hold it L at the end of the night. You know what I'm saying? It is what it is.
Oh.
It just happens to be the case that he lost. We'll see what happens on
the Oh.
Hey.
Late.
He must have got Sprint.
I don't know what he got.
Oh, so what did you remember? What did you actually say it about Deontay Wilder?
Yeah, because I was like, he came to the ring all showy with that big ass suit on and showing all, being showy. And I don't like showy niggas.
So you saying the irony is being showy he lost.
I would call it irony.
He just got his ass kicked that night, and that just is what it is.
Yeah, well, I knew he was going to lose from being all showy.
Yeah.
You know, I've never seen an extra showy ass nigga win a lot. I haven't seen that a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen a nigga that's about his business and didn't care about putting on a show go in and kick some ass. I've seen that. And yeah, you take L's too. But if you go in there about your business, the L don't seem as big when you showboating and then you take that L.
Yeah.
Cause now you showed your ass before you got in there, and now you got your ass whooped. And everybody remember how you came in there. Hey, man, dog, if you come in with humility, you can lose with humility.
Yeah.
You come in with that all that showy shit, and then you take that L, nobody's going to care about how I'm finna fuck the word up. I don't care about how gracious you are in your loss, because you showed up showing your ass.
Yeah, well, he wasn't gracious when he came with that bullshit.
That's what I'm saying, man. So, I mean, I do agree with some of that DJ said, but at the end of the day, man, Tyson's losses, I seen them coming too.
Mike Tyson?
Yeah. I remember being in high school when I called it.
Once you reach the pinnacle or the apex, there's nothing else left for
you
to do.
Yeah, ain't nothing else but the downside.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah.
So, but Wilder ain't hitting no apex.
Nah, I don't think
he
so.
He just
either.
Showing his ass and got his ass whooped. That to me is more memorable.
I think Deontay Wilder. I think for so long, especially with the emergence of the UFC,
mm-hmm.
we have been looking for the emergence, and that's what hurt boxing the most. That
the heavyweight fell
the
off.
Heavyweights fell off.
That's right. That's what was exciting
and they
about Wilder.
Waiting, and then Wilder came out, and I remember before he's talking a lot of stuff and everything, mm-hmm. and I heard the name, but. I just still wasn't into it. And
what was that shit he said?
What
about like black history? And it was,
well,
to this day.
Oh, he said that?
To this day. Or some shit he was saying.
Well, that racist, I'm not in.
He was riding that, looking all, I'm like, see what I'm talking about?
Come on, man.
And he is true to his name, because every swing was wild.
Oh, really?
Oh, man, he swings like with a over-the-top windmill type of style. It's like, dog, you fighting a boxer, that shit ain't gonna win.
He fought the Tyson Fury looked like a brawler.
Hey, man, Tyson Fury got under them wild ass swings, was jabbing and counter punching and multiple, you know, flurries right up in the chin. What you gonna do when you swinging from your elbow, from your shoulder,
mm-hmm.
windmilling? Hey, man, I mean, if one of them windmills land, might hurt.
Yeah,
but if you get up under that and you hit his ass a bunch of times. That windmill ain't gonna have no power, you know. And then don't show up with blinking lights on your costume, nigga. If that's what you're gonna do.
Stupid.
It was very dumb.
Very.
I hated it.
I can't believe I can't believe he's actually using it as an excuse.
Yeah. See, that's what make me feel like it's some shit in the water. You know, because they gave him that first one. I went back after watching that second.
Well, the first one, I was going back to what he said. The first one, he didn't. When you going against the champ, see, if he would have did this last time, he would have won. You got to knock the champ out.
Yeah. Okay.
You can't go the distance and not knock the champ out.
You got to destroy the man. You can't win on points on that.
Right. Yeah.
I get you. Well,
that's the way I look at it.
When Tyson lost,
I watched that fight.
It was memorable at the time.
Yeah. Maybe, I didn't watch it live. And this I think one, I watched the replay.
And this one might be memorable at the time. We might forget about it later. I don't know.
I don't think we'll
But if I put Tyson's loss to Buster Douglas and Holyfield against Wilder's loss, I'm going to say Wilder's loss was worse. Just because, you know, he didn't show up to kick ass. He wasn't no frizz, no thrizz.
He
I came here to
every
fight.
Round,
every
like.
Round. After the second one, he was done.
You know that this guy had the nerve to fire his trainer? He said he willing to die.
And then he talked that shit about being better than Mike at his prime? Nigga. I understand you want to be confident. You supposed, it's kind of like the rap game. You want to be confident in your abilities.
Yeah.
But be realistic at the same time. Yeah. Nigga wasn't realistic, man.
Come on, man.
He what? Come on, dog.
So he fired his trainer for saving his life.
Don't cut his dick off, man.
Come on, Dwayne Wade, dog. Come on, man. Hey.
Boosie caught a little hell for that.
He did.
His mama told him to stay off social media.
Boosie out the chain.
Come on, dog.
All right. Second half of the show, we usually talk some fuckery. We got a few voicemails in, and we got more. We're going to get to those. But for right now, we're going to get to some of this fuckery. The Pop Smoke.
We back on that?
Hey, man.
I'm shutting up, man. I'm going to let it go.
Can we get a gunshot from Pop Smoke?
Okay.
What'd you think?
Sure.
Okay. Let me unlock my laptop here.
See there? You can't even pop the shot off.
Make sure you follow us on our social media platforms.
You can't pop the shot off for Smoke.
We try and post some humorous stuff.
Smoke needs a shot.
To get you going through the day.
Oh, we doing that again?
Hey, man. I'm typing too fast. I don't have my fingers on the home row.
He got that Apple shit over there, man.
No. But anyway, Smoke got popped. And
yep.
The police have hit a roadblock.
Really? They can't find who did it?
No. People are refusing to talk.
Yeah, no snitching rule.
Yeah. So, and also the people that they did talk to, their stories have been changing.
Hey, snitches get smoke. So. I'm trying to stay away from you, man.
You sure you trying hard enough?
I'm trying, man. Come on, man. I mean, damn, man. How many rappers got to get killed for y'all kind of see the shit? Jay-Z said it, man. About the money phone is stacks of dollars up against your ear. You look clownish.
Yeah.
They keep doing it. And what happens to them jokers, man, when they do it? I remember Boosie was the main one. Nigga, you don't run shit around here. He put a stack on his up to his head like he talking on the phone. I'm like, see, Boosie, you know, I ride with you usually when you talk, but that is not the move.
Shout out to Boosie.
Jay-Z tried to tell these niggas, man. He tried. And the ones that didn't get it or refused or went against it, just like when Bill Cosby, like, put your pants up, every niggas got mad.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what did Bill say that was wrong? He didn't. He spoke the truth.
Yeah.
And niggas celebrated when he got locked up.
That's crazy.
Because he told him to pull their pants up.
Yep.
Come on, dog. And I posted some shit earlier today. what's my man named? The Jewish guy that was touching on everybody.
Oh, Weinstein.
Weinstein. Weinstein got locked up.
Right.
Supposedly, I guess. I don't know for sure.
Well, he's convicted.
Yeah. And nothing. We ain't seen no jokes.
No, they out there.
Ain't not really.
No, not like, no.
No. When Bill Cosby got it, all niggas had jokes for days.
But you know what's
put dude, the pills in the people.
This dude still has some good-looking women with him.
Hey, man. I'm just saying.
They know what they going after.
The same energy wasn't kept.
Nope.
At all. And so, come on, man. Just like this rap shit, man. It's like, hey, man, somebody got to say it. I'm trying to stay away because, you know, we lost some people when Nipsey got hit.
Yeah, that wasn't a fan of that.
And we wasn't wrong. That's the thing. We was the ones that was right.
Hey, look here.
I'm going to stay. See, I said too much. I'm back out again.
Where that next voicemail coming from?
All right, man. Thank you. The next one is.
We save you.
Save me. The next one coming from the 830. That's your boy. Let's see what he got to say. Hold up.
You know me. I'm a baller, Black. I'm a ball till I fall. I have a
ball attack, huh?
If I play for Southern, I'll
hog the swag.
I'm still a deep dealer.
I have all the crack.
What up, man?
Yeah.
Hey, Valentine's Day was awesome. I agree with y'all. You know, should have to take that day to celebrate. But I'm in a different place. That's my anniversary.
He's smoking.
I just knocked down 19 in the game. So, we ain't got a support team like y'all do. So I switched it up. I take one day out the month, and we have a date day. And it lasts about 8 to 3 o'clock. So that's what I'm doing, fellas. Oh, last year there was a conversation about being a better husband. And I really took that to heart, because it's not something we really talk about. And it's just something to put out in the air. So every day, I try to do something. You know, it's not a whole bunch, but it's something. Anyway, good to holler at you. Y'all have a good day.
You know what's funny? I just got a text from him.
Really? Just now?
Yeah, with his daughter.
Well, look at that.
Yeah.
Shout out to Carl, man.
Hey, we did do that, man.
Yeah.
We don't, as men, we don't get together and say, man, what can I do to be better?
Yeah.
We always talk about, God damn,
I tried to do that today before we started this show. I was like, nigga, she ain't gonna be
happy. No. What lyrics was he talking about?
That was Big Pokey.
Okay.
I just want to say, shout out to him, man.
Yeah.
Because I know he listened.
Yeah.
Nigga, that was why y'all still talking? That was on the second Big Pokey album. You know me, I'm a baller, Black. I'm a ball till I fall, have a ball attack. If I played for Southern, I'd hawk the swag. If I was still a D-dealer, I'd have all the crack.
Yeah.
Squash the chat. I'm going to see. I keep going. Anyway, yeah, that shout out to him for that, dog. That hit me right there.
Yeah, I can tell.
Oh, that's my shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, to this day, Big Pokey was the best one to come out the Screwed Up Clip.
Mm.
All day.
All day.
Yes, sir.
All day, every day. Hustling every to get paid.
That's right. Don't shot connector, red dot reflector, 50-pound dissector when I'm buying from Hector. Come on, I can do this all day with you.
All right. Well, why don't you post some of his albums?
Shit, I will. Now that you said it.
Do
shout out to Carl, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, being a better husband, I encourage y'all to do that. We talked about that a while back. It's just a conversation that we don't have as men about doing some good stuff, you know.
I remember us doing that.
Whatever.
Talk.
Yeah.
That was deep.
Yeah. So, whatever the case may be. Think about it, and if you're a friend of mine, he reminded me of that.
He's a friend of mine.
He reminded me, so that kind of made me feel like, well,
I spoke to him the other day. He just sent me a text.
I did just speak to him. He did just send me a text.
Yeah.
So, yeah, make sure y'all focus on that. Yeah, that's one of the reasons my wife want to move.
Yeah.
Support system.
Well, I mean, there's something to it.
Man,
that's why I'm on this side of town, honestly.
Say that.
Nigga, I was not moving north of I-10 at all. Yeah. That was never in the plan. But the old lady's a north sider. So I'm always on the south side. I go back any day. I got a truck. I drive.
Yeah.
I can get there.
Yeah.
So, you know, you just about
how much more breath we got?
We got
two more?
Two more. Yeah.
All right. Let's go with that next one.
All right. This next one is coming from what? 830. Let's see if he start with another rap, nigga. Let's see.
Hey, I forgot to hit y'all with the timestamp. Hey, it's 7:59, 27 February, 2020. Carl Kirkendall.
Hey.
Have a good day.
All right, dear. Hit us with that timestamp. There we go, brother.
Yeah, but what is today's timestamp?
Today, hold up. Let's see. What day is it?
It is Saturday, the 29th of February, 2020.
All right, then. There we go. Shout out to Google.
Hey Siri, what's today's date?
It's Saturday, February 29th, 2020.
Siri sound more white.
Right. Yeah. Hey Siri, what's today's date?
It's Saturday, February 29th, 2020.
Nigga, do you need to do it again?
Yeah.
All right.
Hey Siri, tell me something that happened on February 29th.
I found this on the web.
I'm on it.
Ha! Nothing. Oh, I got one for you.
Go ahead.
Tell me a joke.
What does a nosy pepper do? It gets jalapeno business.
Venucci! Shout out to Google.
Hey, Siri, what is a dirty Sanchez?
Oh, shit.
Here's what I found.
I found this on the web for what is a dirty Sanchez?
Ask Google.
Well, I know a Sanchez.
Go ahead.
And she dirty.
Go ahead. Go, man.
Hold on, man. Just wait for me to talk. Hold up. What is a dirty Sanchez?
According to Mel Magazine, the dirty Sanchez was probably the first ridiculous sex act that I ever heard of, and it really achieves the Urban Dictionary trifecta. It's kind of sexist, kind of racist, and full on questionable. It's believed to have had its origins as almost an ass-to-mouth blooper.
Google for the win again. Come on, dog. We should.
Okay, let me ask you.
Let's not keep doing
Google
it.
This. Hold on, let me see. Hold on. Hey, Siri, what is a bukkake?
Oh, shit.
Okay. I found this on the web.
What is a bukkake? Check it out. Ask Google.
What is a bukkake?
According to Collins Dictionary, a sexual practice in which several men ejaculate on the face of an individual woman. Collins English Dictionary.
Google for the win again. Fuck iPhone. Nigga, the Google Pixel got it, dog.
Let's try this one. Hey, Siri, what is a donkey punch?
Here's what I found.
Go ahead, Google.
What is a donkey punch?
According to your dictionary, a sucker punch, especially one delivered to the back of the neck, head, or the kidneys of a sexual partner who is crouching on all fours, also used metaphorically.
Well, I'm telling you, dog. Hey, man, I won't be mad if you denounce your Apple shit. Just acknowledge that the Google Pixel, man, got y'all beat, man.
Come on, man.
Come on, man. You iPhone aficionados and you're sitting up on your ivory tower looking down at the rest of us plebeians.
Yeah.
Hey, man, Google got it, man.
Yeah.
All day. You just saw it. You just heard it.
Okay.
Hey, nigga, donkey punch.
Yeah.
Bukkake. Come on, man. We got it, man.
Okay.
You done fucked up my algorithm now. I'm going to have a bunch of dirty shit every time I open up Google, man.
All right, move along here in the Shoot from the Hip show. We got one more, bro.
We got one more, man.
Let's go.
Well, you a song, bitch. All
right, shout out to LaShira.
Yeah, shout out to LaShira, man. All right. There you go. LaShira. The next one here is coming from the what? The 832, and that is what? Home Backyard. Let's see what they got to say. Hold on.
What's up, fellas? What's up, D-Reese? It's that boy, too, man. You know, I still been listening, man. You know, I'm going to be doing that. But I ain't called in a minute. Shit, man. Shout out to that boy, Reese. Say he going to go to church, man. Next Super Bowl Sunday, man. For the wife. I see y'all there, dog. I don't want y'all to just skip past that. It just went by like a blur. But I caught that. Man. Shit. And I mean, there's a lot to talk about because I missed the two shows, maybe three, four, I don't know. But just touching on that one, man, I got to shout y'all boy wife out, man, because you boys are something else. I'm going to leave that right there. Shit, what else it was? God damn it, I knew that was going to happen at the Hitchin' Back because I just listened to two, three shows. I don't know, man. But, man, I love the part, man. I like the way that boy Monty put down, you know, that shows that y'all real homeboys, where that boy just come out, because it ain't scripted. The boy said, name five things. He hit him out the park. Which, if you listening to the show, you probably just got to, you got to at least get through listening to Rich. And Monty, I think you're a little more complicated. You basic, but you complicated. But, shit, I felt you on the gay shit. That's what it was on that other show. Oh, Montoya's, man, like, that's some real shit. But man, I'm out here listening, dog. That's it, man. Oh, and BYT, man, you need to invite the boy Montoya. So, you asking, at least try to invite the man, though. Yeah, y'all got to get a better relationship. Hey. All right, man, I'm out here listening.
Shout out to that boy, too, man.
BYT full of shit. That's what it is.
All right, well, I'm not gonna say that.
Fuck all that.
You will. I'm not. Me and him have a good relationship.
That's why it's so fucked up.
Okay.
Yeah. And y'all down the street.
Yeah.
You got to pass your house to get to my house.
That's true.
What was you talking about, five things?
Oh, when you was like, because somebody said, man, do Reese hate everything?
Oh, yeah.
And you was like, man, name five things I like or I love or whatever. And yeah. I rattled them off.
Yeah.
So, yeah, two caught that. He also caught that you said you're going to go to church on Super Bowl
Sunday. Thanks for reminding me.
Boy, because you said it on the show. Now, if you didn't do it next year,
I'm going to do it.
You better.
Yeah.
Because it's on wax.
It's on wax.
You better hold true.
I'm gonna do it.
All right, nigga. We gonna make a reminder of that.
Dress up. We gonna go to church. We might go.
Oh, you gonna dress up? You gonna put a tie on and shit?
I put a tie on.
Nigga, I'm wearing some Adidas.
No.
My Theater. Stepping in.
I meant to say troops.
Wow. I remember that.
Yeah.
who did that one? You remember
I
that?
Don't know.
I remember it was like a elementary school thing we did.
Yeah.
Yeah, anyway. If y'all remember that, call in, man, and finish that rhyme for us.
What, snakeskin boots?
Snakeskin boots, yeah. That's it. Look all at right. you. Why you got bars in your head somewhere?
A little bit.
Yeah, I see.
All right. Moving on with this fuckery. Garth Brooks did a show in Detroit.
Garth Brooks.
Yeah. Now, he wore a Sanders jersey.
Yeah.
Well, the racist rednecks of America.
Not a Bernie Sanders.
Right.
But a
Barry Sanders.
Barry Sanders.
According to Garth Brooks, he's the best player ever in NFL history. He was paying respect to him. Mm-hmm. But rednecks all across America thought he was supporting
that boy supporting Bernie.
I'm out. I ain't fucking with him.
Get his ass up out of here.
Freaking socialist.
God damn. Look, man. Every white voice we do kind of sound like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fucking. Oh, I'm done.
Yeah. But, you know, that shows you how people are always on edge and always ready for some shit.
So it's the political climate, man.
That shit is dumb.
It gives people something to worry about.
Man, people are idiots.
People need shit to worry about, man.
They got plenty.
Can't be like me, dog.
Go to the mailbox. Shit.
People have to give a damn about something, man. That's just what it is. That's the way the world works. That's why these 24-hour news channels work.
Man, they killing it.
Gives you something to worry about. Maybe we ought to augment our shit and just be the sky is falling all the time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, boy, we blow up.
We get canceled like
You know, we wouldn't get canceled. They be eating that shit up.
Hey, you know that, what's our man? White dude, he crazy as fuck. He was hating on the Sandy Hook shooting. He did an interview with Minister Louis Farrakhan. You should check it out.
Yes, I remember that guy.
Yeah, I can't remember his name.
I don't know his name, but I remember that. Yeah.
Yeah, so go check that out.
Yeah, go check that out, which we didn't say.
Yeah.
You just figure it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we didn't name names.
What the fuck, or whatever his name is. He crazy as fuck.
Yeah, crazy white. Just Google crazy white guy and leave Florida out of it.
Yeah. So I had two things I want to talk about. We was waiting on a special female caller to call in. Look like she's not going to make the cut. So we're going to move on with this one.
We going to talk about it?
No, not that.
Why not?
You want to talk about it?
Hell yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm gonna start with the first one. I'm going to give a, let's see, no text, nope.
Don't worry about it, man. We can handle it.
Okay.
I can speak from a woman's perspective.
Really?
No.
Okay. All right. I got two things I want to talk about, and this is fuckery. All right. So I posted a picture, and it's been all over the internet of Trump with some black people.
Mm, with praying hands on him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Diamond and Silk were there.
Diamond and Silk.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Are those their real names?
I call them the Ghetto Twins.
Yeah. So, responsibility.
Let me ask you this. Okay. So anytime somebody does something stupid, there are skit shows and memes and people doing some pretty innovative comedy things on Instagram, social media about them. Now, we as black people, maybe overly sensitive, you know, when you mock us.
Yeah.
They are black.
Okay.
Can Saturday Night Live mock them
with their
ghetto ass?
Yeah.
And be okay.
You not get no backlash?
Right.
Yeah.
Really?
All day.
Because they're not.
Early in the show, we talked about Weinstein and Cosby.
Yeah.
The differences. All right. So, yeah, they can get mocked easily.
Yeah.
And people laugh at it.
Okay.
I believe that. I sure hate they did it, but, hey, they probably got their pockets laced, man.
Yeah.
You don't put yourself out there that bad without getting some residual on the back end. Something had to come with that.
Yeah. But I'm talking about scripted by white people. They deserve it.
They deserve it. No,
we don't fuck with them.
I think white folks know better than to do that.
It's obvious they coons.
Yeah.
They look stupid as fuck. They ghetto as fuck. They baps.
You know, because white folks in Hollywood tend to be tone deaf when it comes to racial shit.
They are.
Except that I think this is
because it's liberal versus conservative.
Exactly. It's on the pulse enough where they know they better leave that one alone. But some black folks within the white camp can do it. I think that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
All right. So you got something you want to bring up, dog. It might be a little controversial. Yeah, we going.
All right. I was trying to get a female in here to talk about this subject.
Yeah, we don't need them. We misogynistic over here.
Got a big beat. You got to remember her from ESPN. Damn.
You see, Reese got tied up watching the TV again, y'all. This is why you can't really do a show with the TV on.
You got black.com.
Really? I don't know. She kind of was.
Okay.
Look like a Muppet.
Yeah.
Yeah, I am.
She do.
I'll pay her.
Okay. All right. So, you know.
Nigga, is it good, man?
Hell, you want some?
No, I'm good.
My bad. You don't eat.
I do. I just don't snack like that.
All right. So I know I need a female. And every female listening to this show,
call up and tell us where we're wrong. Because I know whatever this is, I don't know what he's about to bring up.
Okay.
But I'm pretty sure I got an opinion on it.
All right. You remember Nipsey Pass, right?
Okay. I don't know why this just keeps coming up.
Well, Kodak Black took a shot.
Who?
Kodak Black.
Okay. I couldn't tell.
Took a shot. At Lauren London.
I remember that, yeah.
Okay, now Kobe Bryant is not in the rap world, so you're not going to get that.
He rapped.
Whatever.
He rapped.
However, Vanessa
How
Bryant.
How long you got to wait?
Kobe Bryant is my age, or our age.
Yeah.
41. So his wife was 5 years younger than him.
Okay.
Because he met her when he was. I don't know if they got married, but I know he met her. He was 23 and she was 18.
Yeah, way back. When Kobe was rapping.
Well.
Yeah. Damn, nigga.
On set of a video.
Yeah, exactly.
I got popcorn on.
I know. But your microphone, I bet that bad boy looked like some shit over there.
Nigga, you crazy.
All right.
$500 mic, nigga.
Yeah, whatever, nigga. You got a bunch of debris on that bitch.
I do.
Uh-huh.
Well,
Look, he's shoveling.
Two questions.
Who?
Well, one
what,
question.
What happened? For what?
So Vanessa Bryant is single now.
Yeah, instantly.
Instantly. Single, celebrity,
mm-hmm.
Rich,
mm-hmm.
Widow.
Yeah.
As a man, married man, sometime once. Sometime twice, sometime three.
Sometime three times later.
A week.
Yeah.
Maybe more, just all depending. Right. Me and my wife engaged in some activities with the door closed.
Right on.
Now, she's 36. She mm-hmm. got a long way to go, mm-hmm. providing there's no sudden death.
Right.
She's a celebrity by being connected to Kobe.
That's right.
When is it appropriate, based on how we've all taken this, not you, because you kind of.
See, don't put me in that corner. Just go on and ask the question.
When, how long does she have to wait before she can have sex again?
About as long as it takes you to chew that popcorn, nigga. That's about how long.
You saying she could be fucking right now?
Man, look here.
You kidding me?
Nope.
I'm not kidding you. You know, everybody got their own take on how long it should be. But the fact of the matter is, women got a dick in a box.
Vanessa?
All of them.
She lives in Calabasas or L.A.
Whatsoever. All of them got a dude in the wing that would immediately step in if given the green light.
Really?
Yes, all of them. No doubt. So, I mean, you know, some dude's probably going to be respectful about it. because that was a high name, you know, high caliber dude.
She also inherited at least $200 million. At least.
All that. So, you know, she got to mourn, of course. Mm-hmm. If she's indeed mourning. We don't know what their relationship was like.
She's mourning.
You sure?
She's mourning.
Okay, I'll let you tell it. I'm not in their house. I can't say that.
Of course.
Yeah, all I know is there's a little grace period where you got to fall back a little bit. I saw Lauren London do it. She fell back a little bit.
Do you think Lauren London's had sex since Nipsey died?
Yeah.
Really?
I do. Yeah. Come on, dog.
You believe that?
Yeah.
You believe somebody?
What punitive action can she have for doing it?
There's nothing. No, it's not a crime.
Exactly. She had a dick in the box. She did. Dude's probably, you know, just, I'm here if you need me. You know, sorry for your loss. Not your lost people. It's sorry for your loss. And
you believe on the weekend, not too late, recently, Lauren London text somebody and said, WYD.
Yeah.
That's normally how it starts.
Yeah. It's normally a you up.
Yeah.
Something like that happened. Man, that girl, man, come on, man. Somebody was at her. It's facts of the matter, man.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not
okay,
a thing.
Okay, so going back to Vanessa Bryant.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so does she go on a girl's trip?
She don't need no girl's trip. She just go on a trip. Come on, dog. You believe, because I've seen her. She's an attractive lady.
Yeah.
Dudes, without knowing any better, gonna shoot at her. So, obviously, sooner or later, the right one gonna say the right thing to her, and it's gonna be on. Yeah.
Do they get social media action? Did she post them?
Well, if she's smart, no. No, we wouldn't know about it. You understand? But I'd bet all my money on that. It's done went down already.
With Lauren London?
Both of them.
No fucking way.
Both of them.
No, both of them. B-O-F-M.
B-O-F-M. Both of them.
No way.
Ooh, I love your accent. How do you say it? Both of them.
You know that I saw the end of the other day on Twitter. You can control this vibrator with an app, and the girl put it, and she. You could, I would maybe that.
I'll say this.
I think she'd be grieving too hard.
I'm privy to some of that kind of action. I'll say that, and I'll leave it where it's at.
Okay. So you believe that Vanessa Bryant had dick in the glass?
Oh man, maybe more than one. Yeah. Probably somebody close. See, man, look here.
A driver like on power.
See, something like that. Look, I've said anybody that's ever followed me through social media and all that. I've always had this thing about men or women being friends with the opposite sex, and I've always said that they're either both or one of the two really just want to get with the other one. All the time. So if you a dude with a bunch of female friends, they want to get at you. Or you want to get at them. I ain't said nothing.
Okay.
I ain't said nothing. All I'm saying is, and especially on the female side, female, you know, you always hear these, back in the day when I was young and running the street, you would hear these females say, I don't hang with a lot of females because they just too messy. All my friends are males. And all I heard was, you attention starved. And yeah. You got a bunch of dudes that like to fuck you that's hanging around. And you like the attention. That's it. So, yes, dog. Yes, there's a dick in the glass around them at all times. That's it.
Okay. 100%.
I wish somebody would call and refute that. Because y'all be full of shit if you did.
I'm just not believing that.
I do. 100%. Mm-mm. Now, see, you said when I was saying that, you was like, so what you trying to say? Well, I can say this. D. Reese got friends. I don't get it. I'm like, what the fuck is that? What is that? And I stay out of it. I kind of say a little bit, and I back out.
Yeah.
I don't know the depths of their relationship, but I know what I know as being a man in this world. I know what's up.
Yeah.
Now, you could be willfully ignorant to it. You can act like it's not a thing.
Shout out to the shit.
Shout out to the shit. You can be willfully ignorant to it, or you can be knowledgeable of it and not go there.
Okay.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
That's a choice you make. But nigga, believe me, if y'all got a female friend and y'all calling y'all selves friends, one of y'all want to fuck the other one. Stop playing. I don't have no female friend. Straight up, out the gate.
You fucked them all.
No, I didn't. You did that last show. Stop doing that.
Okay.
You know, I don't have any female friends. I got females I'm friendly with.
Okay.
But I wouldn't call them my friend. I'm not calling them.
That's black.com right there.
I can't tell.
Wait.
Once again, y'all, we over here looking at TV. Reese saw a white chick that looked like she's doable. Either way, back to what I'm saying, though. I don't have any of those because I know what's up. Either I want them or they want me. That's it.
Yeah.
And that's how I go. And I would guarantee that's 98% of every situation out there is that.
Shot for the shit.
There you go. Yeah. Don't burp over that, nigga.
Yeah.
Right on. I know you don't believe. God damn, how much you got, man?
Okay. Shot to the shit.
Yeah. All right, man. Well, yeah. So that friend zone shit. Stop it.
Okay.
Vanessa got a dick in the glass.
Oh, okay. So
Lauren London got a dick in the glass.
Let's say.
Stop.
Let's just say that the ignorance that is Montoya's is wrong.
I'm not. But okay.
And they are not what you're saying.
Okay. Let's say I'm wrong.
I'm curious to know, because you're gonna get horny, you're gonna get urges.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna take showers and
mm-hmm.
and caress yourself and be like, damn, like, how long do I wait? And I'm just interested in how long does one
how wait. Long do you break the glass that the dick's in?
Shoot from the hip.xyz is the website. 559-825-7468 is the phone number. Shoot from the hip1@gmail.com is the email. I am MANN_AT_ARMS. He is
MONTOYISK on Twitter.
Yeah, so man, we hope y'all following us on our social media platforms. You can find us on Twitter. You can find us on Facebook.
And Twitter? Twitter?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's when you take your index finger and your thumb and you twist the titty nipple. That's what Twitter is. You know what Google is? That's when you put your thumb in the booty hole.
Yeah. All right, so females, y'all heard that last part of the conversation. Give us a call. Let us know how you feel. This is Shoot for New Show. Holla at us. Later.
Inside the room. Boom, inside the room. Boom, inside the room. Boom, inside the room. Boom, hey, time, come on. Boom, what? Boom, outside, come on. Come on. Boom, inside, come on. Boom, come on. Boom, outside, come on. Boom, come on. Boom, west side, come on. Boom, come on. Boom, most city, come on. What? Hey, time, come on. What? Bed time, come on. What? What? VA, come on. What? Feel hard, bone hard, walls nest, no stress. I'm talking about.